Hello, Moto.
Hello, good
Tan,
morning. How
hello, good morning. How are you?
Dieguito. Nice here. Getting ready for class. Waiting for Mr. Robert to start talking, Mister. How are you,
Me?
Mister? Yes, you, Mr. Robert, you are Robert. How are you,
Yes.
Mr. Robert?
More or less.
More or
I am
less.
bored.
You are bored. What happened to you?
Sí,
What happened?
estoy aburrido. La cuarentena, eso pasa. No puedo salir a ningún lado.
Not only
Extraño mis taquitos.
you. Oh, yes, tacos. Where do you like eating tacos, mister?
En la esquina.
Exactly. Everyone, Diego is also bored because he can't go out. ¿O no, Diego?
Teacher, teacher.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, what is it? Yes, okay. Okay, guys.
Teacher, ¿usted de la salsa pica?
Yes, it's Te perdí, Dieguito. Dieguito, Robert.
¡Oh! Bless you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Eso lo anotamos, ¿verdad, profe?
Yes, get ready your notebook. Uy.
Teacher, ¿en dónde
Yes.
se encuentran las clases grabadas?
Y library o biblioteca. Yes, library o biblioteca, right there you can see the classes. All the classes are recorded by date. So it means today I write in the biblioteca or library. Yes, I write November 24th. Yes, and I have two classes, so you will see two videos. Okay, so right there, here, just click on the video, click on the class that you want to see, 24, 20, 23rd, or maybe the last week. Yes, and right there.
Okay, teacher, thank
Okay,
you.
guys, so I'm going to call the roll, well, the list. because some students they know this is the list. Okay, so what happened? The list, right here. Diego, present?
Yes.
Yes. Kevin, present?
Present.
Thank you. Barbara, present?
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Javier, Sebastián?
What, teacher?
Present.
Yes. Present.
Thank you. Javier, ¿ya tienes el número de tu mamá o papá, el que me vas a dar?
No, teacher.
No, no sé si anden por allá. Pregúntaselos, ¿no? Para que me lo pases hoy, porque ayer se me pasó para meterlos al grupo y pasarte el link para que ahí mandes evidencias. Ok, mañana te explico cómo va a ser. Ok, José Roberto is not in class. Ay, Robert.
Hello.
Ah, ok, sorry, Robert is here. Ok, Espinosa Triay. Yes.
Yes.
Tamara.
Present.
Thank you. Dennis, you are here.
Yes, teacher.
Thank you. Brittany.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Peter.
Present.
Thank you. Daniela Valenzuela.
Present.
Thank you. Leti Ameyali.
Present.
Fernando Chavero.
Present.
Thank you, Fer. Rodrigo García.
Present.
Okay. Max Hurtado. Yes, Max acaba de entrar. Vale Rojas.
Here, teacher.
Thank you. Reina Lilian. Yes. Eder.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Coronado. Yes, Coronado is here. José Antonio.
Present.
Sebastián.
Present.
Christopher Abraham. No, Christopher Abraham. No, that's true. Strange. Okay. Ingrid.
Present.
Caro.
Present.
Ángel Venegas Gómez. No. Ángel Díaz.
Here.
Thank you, Mr. Adriana Camila.
Present.
Okay. So we are here in class. Thanks, guys. So yes, today we're going to check these phrases. These are called Here I am going to write the title, phrasal verbs. That is the title. Sorry, I didn't write it before. Phrasal verbs. And yesterday we were checking this about get back. So váyanlos anotando para que no se les olviden estos. Okay, because they are really, really important for you to memorize them. Get back, it means to return. Yesterday I told you, return. Yes, regresar. Thank you, Sebas. Give me a moment. Okay, got it, Sebas. Thank you. Thanks a lot, mister. Okay, so these phrasal verbs, yes, the number one is get back, again, to return, regresar, yes, examples. My cousin gets back from New York. This is in present, okay? In past, Leo got back from Canada last week. Okay. Okay. So get back means regresar de un lado, okay? Present in past. You know how to use this present in past. So that's the reason I'm writing this one. Okay? Number two. Get lost. This is equals to be lost, comma, or something is lost. Algo que se pierde, okay? O alguien que se perdió. For example, Mario gets lost in the woods. Mario is a person. Se perdió, se pierde. Mario gets lost in the woods. Or Monica got lost in Mexico City yesterday. Yes, Monica se perdió, got lost in Mexico City yesterday. So this is for a person, for a thing. Yes, you can say, I got lost my favorite toy. I got lost, perdí. I got lost my favorite toy. Yes. Liz got lost. Got lost her sneakers. Yes. In Six Flags. Sometimes happens, yes. Liz perdió her sneakers in Six Flags. So this get lost is for two things, for a person or for an object. Okay, ¿ya copiaron?
Yes.
Yes, ¿los demás también? ¿Ya me puedo pasar a otra hoja?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, next. get on. That is equally to say to go on a type of transportation. For example, yes, a type of transportation, bus, car, yes, Batman the Ride in Six Flags, your bicycle, why not an animal, a horse, etc. Okay, so get on. Saul gets on a bus at 3 o'clock. Saul se sube, gets on a bus at 3 o'clock. Yes. My brother got on a horse in the Independence Parade. My brother se subió on a horse in the Independence Parade. Parade is desfile, okay? So remember, when is the Independence Parade? Yes, you see the group of charros of Mexico, yes, on horses. Okay, so this is, of course, Diego Isaac. Next, get up. I told you yesterday to wake up. For example, Marianne gets up at 7 o'clock to go to virtual classes. Marianne se levanta, gets up at 7 o'clock to go to virtual classes. Okay. We got up at 5 in the morning. Yes. To climb a mountain. We levantamos yesterday at 5 in the morning to climb a mountain. Okay, so get up. Ahorita me regreso, no más a ver cuál es la última. Ah. You finish copying?
No, teacher, wait. Oh.
Finish, teacher.
And the last one is get to. It means to arrive to a particular place. ¿Estás tomando notas, verdad, Peter?
Sí.
Ah, ok. Ahorita te veo, ok. Thank you.
Sí.
To arrive, llegar to one particular place. Yes. For example, my family gets to Puebla. Ahí. My family gets to Puebla. Mi familia llega a tu Puebla. My family gets to Puebla. Ok. Liz got to Argentina to climb a mountain. Got to Argentina to climb a mountain last month. Y ya lo complemento. Ok. So, Liz got, llegó to Argentina to climb a mountain last month. Correct? So we have these phrasal verbs. It means combinations with the verb get. Yes? Get on, get up, get to. What is the number one? Get. Ay. Get back and get lost. Okay, so you have to memorize all of these combinations. It means when you check these sentences, you need to be ready to see what is the correct combination you are using. Okay, what is the correct combination? Ready, students? You copy?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, one student.
Yes, teacher.
Yes? You copy, you copy. Yes? Okay. Bueno, ahora sí, vamos a ver how you are going to apply these words in an exercise, okay? So, take out your book. Yes. And let's start with the exercise in page 42. The exercise number 4 that yesterday we didn't finish. Okay, so the exercise is complete the sentences with the correct verbs in the box. Get back, get lost, getting on, getting to, getting up. Okay? So, what is the correct combination? Ready?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so let's comprehend the number one. Tara is to the airport by car. So Tara needs to go to the airport. Yes. Okay, so here we have maybe two sentences, maybe two phrases are suitable, but only one is the correct one. Okay, so somebody can give me one option for the number one. Tara is
getting
what? Getting on or getting to or getting up?
To.
Getting to? Let me check. Exactly, llegando. Tara is getting to the airport by car. Good selection. Number two, Tara and Dan have to from the mountains to the activity center alone. Tara and Dan have to. Okay, so they are on the mountains. Okay.
Getting up.
Getting up from the mountains to the activity.
Get back.
Well, I think get back is like more suitable. Let's check. Yes. Tara and Dan have to get back, return from the mountains to the activity center alone. Alone means solitary. Number three, Tara and Dan are a bus at 5 a.m. in the morning, okay? So Tara and Dan have to be in the bus. Otherwise, phew, they don't go to the trip. Okay, so what is a good combination? What is the correct combination for the number three?
Get on.
Get me on.
Excellent. Remember that I told you this one is for transportation. What is the transportation? The bus. Excellent. Number four, Tara and Dan are early on Monday morning, okay? So they always have to be early on Monday mornings.
Getting up.
Getting up, exactly. Tara and Dan are getting up early on Monday morning, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. I don't know. And you know the last one. Dan hopes he doesn't get lost in the mountains. Okay? Yes, in the mountains. Can I pass to the next activity?
Yes.
Yes, excellent. I like when you have this positive and nice attitude. Yes, teacher, let's go for more. Let's check more exercises. Okay. Look at the examples, then choose the correct words to complete the sentences. Ok, sí tienen ese ejercicio allá abajo ustedes, ¿verdad? Yes?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, ok. We have. We are getting on a bus at 5 o'clock in the morning. I am not taking my keyboard with me next week. We are going. When are we going mountain biking and paddle boarding? Okay, so what are we using here? This is the introduction for the grammar we'll check today. Well, let me explain really fast. They are using this, are getting on, I'm not taking, are we going? Okay, if you check, all the verbs have ing. Getting, taking, and going. The verbs getting, taking, and going represents for today, for you, future. But this future plan, or this future, yes, you have to use it with one specific form. You have to use it with the verb to be. If you use this with the verb to be, yes, you are saying a plan. Yes? So, what is the verb to be? Can somebody help me with the verb to be? No? The verb to be is am, is, and are. Okay, so when you include the verb to be, I am getting, she is taking, you are going, yes, you are saying something in future, okay? And something important you never forget. Time expressions. So every time that you are saying a plan, you have to say a time expression. Yes, obviously for future. Tomorrow, next week, yes, tonight, ahorita es en el día, al rato en la noche, pues es future, yes, tonight, this, and right here, you need to include the different combinations, this week, this month, this year. Okay, so if you want to make a sentence with the future meaning, you have to use am, is, and are, your verb in ing, and your time expression that is something important in this topic. Okay, that's the reason in the sentences. Check in the sentences. The morning, next week. Yes. And right here you have this word that represents time. When is with a circle. Ahí en la pantalla. Okay. So we use the present continuous to talk about what? Here we have three possibilities. The future, now, or now and the future. ¿Cuál escogerían you? The future, now, or now and the future?
Now.
Now. Let's check. Now and the future. Okay, so we are using present continuous for two things. Remember, now, what is your mommy doing right now? Ah, she's working. What is your brother doing right now? Ah, he's taking classes. So for now, for future, what is your mommy doing this morning? Ah, she's cooking breakfast for me. All right, so she's doing something in future. What is your brother doing tomorrow? Ah, he's taking classes at 7 o'clock. That is for future. So this one represents two things, now and the future. Number two, the three examples sentences are about now or future? Now or future?
Future.
Future. Yes. In the morning, next week, and when? They are using time expressions for you representing future. Okay? We never or we usually use a time expression or time word with the present continuous for the future, never or usually?
Usually.
Usually, exactly. So, time expressions, ya te las puse acá arriba, están en rojo. Usually. The sentence number one, in the morning. The sentence number two, next week. Time expressions. Yes? La última no tiene. We don't have a time expression. But we have when. So this one represents time. Okay? So algunas veces no es necesario que pongas tomorrow, next week, tonight, this week, in the morning, etc. If you use when, that one represents your time expression. Okay? ¿Ya puedo quitarme de aquí? Yes.
¿Teníamos que copiar la parte de acá de las palabras?
No, 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 ahorita te doy esa parte. Ahorita te doy esa parte para que sea más acomodado, ¿all right? Ok. So, lo que nos queda de tiempo, exercise, ahí lo tienes, 6 and 7. ¿Ok? 6 and 7. Vamos a hacer the number 7. Answer the questions. So, ahí nada más vas a responder in your notebook. Yes, in your notebook. Right here we have questions 1. Do you think going sailing is dangerous? What is your opinion? For the number 1, do you think going sailing? Right there in the picture you have sailing. So, is it dangerous to go sailing? Yes or no? I think going sailing is for me. And then you say, dangerous or not dangerous because that, in my case, I think going sailing is dangerous. I don't think it is dangerous because I know how to swim. That would be my answer. Okay, ready? Okay, so right there in your notebook. ¿Estás escribiendo, verdad, Peter?
Yes.
Okay, number 2. Do you think going camping is boring? Do you think going camping is boring? Yes, camping is boring.
No.
No. No. No. Because when I go camping, I see many beautiful places. Or I don't know, your personal opinion, okay? So, tienen que escribir su opinión, okay, Peter?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so los quiero ver escribiendo your opinion for the number 2. No escriban la pregunta, only your answer. Espinosa Triay, I don't see you here. Where are you? Ah, okay, thank you. I see you. Yes, sorry. Hasta casi me asustas, niña. Estabas en blanco, en negro. Sorry, de repente sales. I'm here. Okay. Dennis Mosquera. You are working? Yes?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Okay, se va a acabar la primera sesión. I'll see you back at 10 o'clock. Okay,
goodbye.
See you back at 10 o'clock.
Goodbye.
Okay. Goodbye, see you in a moment.
Goodbye, teacher.
Bye, see you in a moment.
Goodbye, teacher.
Bye, Dieguito. ¿Cuál se te rompió?
El espejo de aumento. Aquí ya no veo bien y tengo un espejo de aumento. Y como es con chupón, al momento de sacar.